Hi guys, Dustin here from the Art of Craftsmanship. Today we're going to be making a pen box. I turned a pen on the lathe at my friend Brian's house recently for my grandfather-in-law for Christmas, and I want to make him a nice pen box to go with it. So I'll be using this block of cherry that I got from another friend, and we'll find another piece of accenting wood to go on the sides as well. I'm going to work on a drawing of it now, sketch out a few ideas, and then we can go from there. Bottom, another piece on top. This piece will fold down, it'll close up, and it'll end up, this is what the finished piece will look like. So the whole thing will flip up, and it'll actually be on a hinge here. We'll drill out a small dowel to go in to be the hinge. It'll be real simple. We'll start with 8.5 just to be safe. Mark that. And then we'll cut that down, sand this a little bit, see what we get in wood grain and color around it, and then decide which edge to use. Hit these edges, see how each one looks, and then we'll decide how we want to arrange the box. So this will be the front of the bottom, and this will be the top of the box, and we'll cut that off on the table saw. Trim that down to 2 inches wide, the full length, and then we'll go from there and we'll decide. We'll center it out. Once I cut this on the bandsaw, then we'll center, put a center line on it, and then we'll know where we're going to route out the line for the pen groove to sit in. So now to get this piece of triangle wood out here, I want to keep these together. I don't really want to move this over and work from this end because I want the grain that's inside here when I cut this off to match the grain that's here. So instead of just doing a triangle from this end, I have to lose a little bit of cherry here, but it'll make it worth it when those two pieces of wood line up and you see that grain. It'll carry through one from one piece to the other, so you see that it was all from one piece of wood. And we'll trim off here and here, and we'll cut these angles on the bandsaw. So that's at 60 degrees. So now I can set my bandsaw, surface of the bandsaw, I can set this 60 degrees and I can check it against the blade. Set the table, line up the blade. I know that they're both 60. Tighten this just a little bit. see it cut a little bit outside of the line by the time I got from one end to the other. Here I was outside of that bottom corner. By the time it got down to the end, it was inside of it. That's okay though, because what I'll do is I'll get all pieces together and then I'll sand them together so they all line up. All right, so we're gonna try now using the table saw instead of the bandsaw. I'll see how this works. We'll try. On cleaning that up a little bit, all the edges, get them to line up pretty straight, and then the sides on, and the whole thing will open up and close. And a few more tool marks from the table saw, and that's pretty much good to go. That's pretty nice. It's gonna look real nice. Keep working, take this down a little bit more, and then we're almost there. So with this router, you see I have two hexagonal nuts that come together. You loosen one, you hold one, and you loosen the other, and that's what loosens this router bit. This router on the table that I'm using for the first time doesn't seem to have two. It has a single hex nut. And then it has a round shaft. So we gotta figure out how to get that out. There should be some type of stop. I'm assuming maybe a stop button somewhere to stop it from spinning. Like on a Dremel tool, you have a stop button so that way you can loosen it. But I can't find. Stop. This. No. All right, so we found it, or I should say my brother Devin found it. So there is a lock shaft mechanism in this router, and it's on the other side. It's facing you guys, which is the reason why I couldn't find it. So we'll lock the shaft, and then we'll be able to loosen the shaft and pull the bit out so I can put in the bit that we want to use. So let's see. Lock. Is that locked? Now it's locked. Now I can actually get into it and loosen it. So we got loosened. I can put in the bit that I want to use. Take this one out. Okay, so it looks like the bit is about a little shorter than a half. So we'll run it at a quarter, and then we'll bring it up and do the last quarter. So I'm doing two runs. All right, let's see how we look. Right on, right on. into two problems. One, I wasn't holding it tight enough and it wanted to jump on me. The other problem was that this piece of wood is not tall enough. So when I was with this piece, when I sat it right on here, it's just about the same height of this piece. It needs this, my fence needs to be taller so that way it can run right against it. Run number two was a failure. And I realized what the problem is, I think. So the router bit is spinning a certain way. I'm trying to put it in, but it's spinning like this, so it wants to kick this piece out. So I spin it around, try it the other way, where then it will be pushing it against the fence instead of away from the fence. And we'll hope that works. Pretty nice. Looks like it's a little swervy here, but it doesn't look like it's on this side as much, which is the side that counts, because this is all going to be gone. So, not exactly sure why it did that. Oh, I know why, because it was lifting up some. So I'm going to run that one more time through in this beginning slot. Good. The sides are pretty close. Once I sand them down, a little bit of a rollover, sand these down so they look nice. That channel looks good. All right, the next step in the box, we're gonna work on putting the triangular sides that will act as the hinges for the box. Then what we need to do is plane a few pieces. You can see I planed a couple pieces here already. Couple pieces of pine and then a piece of oak. I'm gonna run a couple more pieces and then we'll decide which ones we wanna use. So I'm gonna use the planer now. The way this grain is, and I like that it kind of matches, but not exactly. So we're gonna go with the oak. Into the scrap pile. So that's where you want to take your time, especially with a power sander like this, because you could really easily trim down too much And then you'd have to start over with another trying. Good. So there we're at 6 7/8. And that's plenty for the pen. The pen's gonna be inside the box. The pen is just under 6 inches, so this will give us plenty of room on both sides of the box. Getting pretty close, just sighting down the wood to make sure the middle of my top is the same depth as the ends. It's a little hard to see that unless you're sighting straight down. That's looking pretty good. A few more passes and I think we'll be ready to move on to the next step. That'll be my dry fitting. I always like to do a dry fitting. I'll do the same thing. Kind of get the clamp set. Try again. I didn't tighten them enough. So we'll get the clamp set to the right spot. Kinda clamp them up, give them a little squeeze to tighten them up just a smidge. And I'll lift it and I'll make a few adjustments if I need to with the wood to line up the tops. That. And then I'll tighten it down to put the final squeeze. All right, put the glue on and glue it up. Don't need too much glue because it's a small spot, but you also don't want to go too little glue. It's better to put a little bit too much on and have to take it off than don't put enough on and then your glue bind is not strong enough. So, nice and thick. All right. Wet excess glue underneath the bench. Adjustments to make sure that this cap is on the right way. One more squeeze. All right. Okay. Almost there. We're getting close. Every little bit matters now. Keep a couple little scrap pieces of wood around to mix up epoxy and nice clean edge. And scrape off that little bit of glue while it's still wet. Be easier than trying to sand inside that space once it's dry. That's just a little bit, but every little bit counts. All right. Oh, that looks great. Whew. All right. We'll let it sit. We'll let it dry. We'll come back to it. Put the hinges in. Be good to go. And we're going to take off the clamp. It's been about maybe half an hour or so. Should be plenty of time for just that little bit of glue to dry. All right. Dry fit it and see how it looks. around over that edge. Do the other one just a little bit. All right. So now, once that's fitted, it comes up. Now this edge here is rounded and this edge is rounded, so the two sharp edges don't catch. And I can close smoothly. I have my mark here and a mark on my other side. So I'm going to put it right between the two and just to the outside of it. And use my spring-loaded center punch to make my starting hole. Do the same thing here. The center. Just have to be careful about drilling straight down. Close enough. Rods to fit. Oh yeah. So I'm just spinning it real slow. Put a little bit of a taper on around the edge over. Amount of glue in. Try to get it into the hole. Get it in and I'll clean it off, make sure we have. Okay, that. Pin, put that there. There's one. So you see we do have some glue squeeze out, but we'll just keep it moving so that way that doesn't dry in between. Finishing touches, put some boiled linseed oil on. I just finished sanding everything. I made sure I got all the spots where there was glue on the surface, because if you have glue on the surface of your wood, the oil won't penetrate. And if there's any glue left behind, we'll know, because we'll see where the oil hasn't penetrated. Putting that last layer of oil and just seeing the character of the wood just shines through. and rule of thumb with linseed oil to protect and nourish your wood. And this is the rule of thumb with axe handles and tool handles, is you oil it once a day for a week, once a week for a month, and then once a month for a year, and then once every year. So this box took maybe 5 or 6 hours. We worked on it over a few nights. So fairly simple box. It's more about the precision, getting everything right, marking off your spots, knowing everything, having all that stuff going right the first time or the second time. And then the final sanding and trimming at the end. Everything works well, opens up, closes, and stays closed. Has a nice snug fit. George, I hope you like it. Merry Christmas.